Warm greetings to everyone. This is Padmashini from Sri SRNM College, Sathu. I'm very happy to share some of my views on the research in comparative literature. There are many scholars who are much interested to pursue their higher education, to pursue their research in comparative studies. For them, I think, I hope that the particular video would be very useful. When we talk about the term comparative literature, it is a different discipline. It is universally accepted discipline. Comparison of world classical literature. We can compare world classical literature with national aesthetic literature. We can compare national literature with regional linguistic literature. Comparative literature, the term comparative literature, inspires the desire of the scholars to pursue their research beyond national boundaries. The research scholars have to study literature across national borders, different periods, languages, cultures, and so many genres. The particular research will be pursued, will be carried out to compare different disciplines like literature and psychology, literature and science, literature and history, literature and sociology, literature and architecture, literature and politics, etc. Comparative literature doesn't have any boundaries. Translation plays an important role in the research of comparative studies. Without translation, we cannot imagine the term, we cannot imagine the research term comparative literature. So translation is most important one. The American concept of comparative literature includes the survey on the relationship between the literature and other fields. René Wallach, he is the most important American comparatist. He analyzed the root of the word, the historical context of the word, and its varied meanings, which had been assigned over time. The research method involves in comparative literature, when we analyze the research methods in comparative studies, it is a mixture of various aspects like description, characterization, interpretation, narration, explanation, and evaluation along with comparison. It includes not only historical context, but also even unrelated ones. We can also compare the unrelated concept of two different literature in a parallel way. Then we focus on the objectives of comparative studies, objectives in the research method of comparative studies. There are so many objectives. The first one is to widen the deepest knowledge of the researcher by tracing the similarities and dissimilarities of the two different literature. There would be, we can consider any two literature. It would be world literature. The other one would be national literature. We can choose national literature. The other one would be regional literature. So we are going to trace out the similarities and dissimilarities of the two different literatures. That is the main objective of the research method in comparative studies. In the research, the two different dimensions are to be classified. First is the linguistics classification. The later one is the cultural classification. Then we are going to analyze the parallels between the two literature. We have to trace out what are all the possible parallel ways in between the two literature. That is one of the main objectives of this study. Then it must be evaluated, the two literatures must be evaluated based on themes, modes, conventions, and the use of folktales, myths between two literatures. Then we have to, as a researcher, we have to obviously seek out and encourage transnational and transcultural experiences and perspectives. As a research scholar, we have to explore social, political, intellectual, and historical context in cross-linguistics and cross-cultural literary studies. Then, focus must be on rethinking of the concept globalization in the term comparative studies. Then, the research scholar must develop critical skills to write effective research papers which may display clear knowledge of research protocols, which must include conventions of proper attribution and citation on a specific topic of literary, cultural, and political relevance. So what is cultural study? What is comparative study? That we are going to see now. The term comparative literature appeared in the age of transition. Susan Basner, she talks about the struggles of the nations like France, Russia, Austro-Hungarian Empire. In those nations, the national identity was inextricably bound up with national culture. Panval Tigam is the most important French comparatist. As a comparatist, he belongs to the French school of comparative studies, he defines the objectives of comparative literature elaboratively as essentially the study of diverse literature in the relations with one another. Comparative literature is now accepted as an independent field by view of the combination of scholarly ideas and opinion. The geographical distance would be the great barrier to all the researchers. So the geographical barrier would be shorted out. How it would be shorted out? The geographical distance between the two different nations, between the differences of opinion among the so many nations, would be considered as the unique cultural study. Then it would be formulated. It would be formulated as a base for all the comparative studies. Next, we are going to see the different schools of comparative study. There are so many different schools of comparative study. The first school is the French school, Russian school, Canadian school, the American school of... There are so many schools. Already we came to know that there are different schools of comparative study. First one is the French school of comparative study, Russian school, Canadian school, and the American school of comparative literature. The French school focuses more on influence study. In the contemporary time period, there are two more schools. Chinese and Indian schools of comparative literature became popular nowadays. The research focuses on the conflicts of opinion amidst these schools, which have already cropped up. The French and German schools give much more importance to the historical perspective. The main objective of this school is to search interstate or intercultural relationships in literature. Next, we are going to see the parallel study. What is comparative study? What is parallel study? That we must understand. The French school of comparative studies established the foundation of solid research, the necessity before any interpretation of an impeccable minute chronology. The obligation of a supranational erudition backed by a good linguistic knowledge which tries to connect the facts pertaining to civilization. The American School of Comparative Studies has given the gifts like broadness in view, the analyzation of broadness, then aesthetic evaluation, universal sensibility to comparative literature. Its main objection was to depoliticize comparative studies by going beyond the political borders of literary text. It has two fields of study, that is parallelism and intertextuality. Parallelism gives no importance to influence intertextuality, which means the influence of the given text to another text. Reception study is part of parallel study. Reception study is part of parallel study. Then the scholars, for their research method, for their research, they can compare Maya Angelou with Jyoti Lanjeshwar. Maya Angelou, she is an Afro-American writer. She is a popular Afro-American writer, black woman writer. Jyoti Lanjeshwar, she is a regional Marathi writer. So the comparative research study would be done after comparing these two world popular writers. Maya Angelou can be compared with Jyoti Lanjeshwar. Both are feminist writers. Both the writers, Maya Angelou and Jyoti Lanjeshwar, try to depict the ideals of women in their writings. Maya, she is well known for publishing autobiographical and female-centered poems. Through all her autobiographical experiences had been explored in her own way of writing, like poems. It had been published as poems by her own way. Maya's works include themes such as self-identity of women, racism, gender discrimination, and freedom of women. Maya's most important works are Phenomenal Woman, Mother, A Cradle to Hold Me, Still Arise, When Great Trees Fall, Equality, Human Family on Aging, Alone and Caged Bird are some of the most popular poems of Maya Angelou. Jyoti Lanjeshwar, she is a prolific writer in Dalit writings. She has been consistently writing in Marathi, and she tries to contribute much to poetry and literary criticism. She is a popular literary critic in Marathi. As a writer, par excellence, she is taught in universities, both in India and abroad. So black feminism is focused by Maya Angelou. Dalit feminism is focused by Jyoti Lanjeshwar. So the researchers can pursue their research by comparing Chitra Banerjee Divakaruni with the Tamil writer Tilakavathi. And Chitra Banerjee can also be compared with the other feminist Tamil writers. Then Canadian Indigenous Cultural Study can also be compared with Tribal Cultural Study of Northeastern India. Caribbean literary text can also be compared with South Asian literary text. Judaism literature can also be compared to Zoroastrian literature. So these are some of the future scope of this research on comparative studies. I think this short video would be very helpful for the budding research scholars to pursue their research in comparative literature. I thank all of you for your patient listening. Thank you. We shall meet in the next video. Thank you.